Are we alone? We've been asking this question since the beginning of civilization, religion, mythology. Are we the only intelligent life out there? But this question is changing. It's not so much out there. The real question is, what if we artificially created intelligent life? Because that's what's happening right now. Most people think that AI is a technology, but really, AI is the outcome of a lot of different technologies, like machine learning that allows us to understand patterns in data, computer vision, seeing, perceiving, and understanding the world around us, natural language processing, communication and language, as well as robotics, giving machines the ability to move in the physical world. We hope that by mastering each of these technologies, we can achieve intelligent, human-level intelligence, AI. But what we're lacking is an interconnectivity between these fields. We've made loads of progress in the past years. AI is much better than it was 20 years ago, but there's no interconnectivity. And right now we're at a point called augmented intelligence, where AI and humans work together to complete each other. And a great example is the field of pathology. Pathologists look at cell images, count cells, measure cells in order to diagnose a patient and then treat them. But usually pathologists would sit in front of their computer screens looking at these images for hours, counting these cells. What I'm doing at SickKids Hospital in Toronto, Canada, is creating an AI to retrieve that information from those images in seconds, and then give that information to the pathologist so that they can focus on what matters, actually diagnosing and treating the patient. And this is augmented intelligence, where we work together to complete each other. But like I said, we're at a point where we're lacking interconnectivity between these fields. We're just getting really good at each of them. And interconnectivity is a major contributor, a major factor in reaching what we call artificial general intelligence, or AGI. Right now, humans are good at what AI is bad at, and AI is good at what humans are bad at. AI can do these quick, repetitive tasks that would usually take us a long time, and humans can make complex decisions using external factors, prior knowledge, we have consciousness, creativity, and this is what AI lacks. But AGI is the goal to close that gap, to make AI good at what AI is good at and at what humans are good at, to make AI good at everything. And so why is AGI important? It will enable us to solve some of the toughest problems in the world in an instant. Humans can only look at a few variables at a time and understand how they relate, but machines can look at billions of data points and understand how each one relates to each other. Imagine if you had the ability to understand how particles interact to form molecules and then to form larger substances. Imagine having that power. That's the power of AGI. Cancer, gone. Interstellar travel, easy. Bridging general relativity and quantum mechanics in a theory of everything, we've got it with AGI. But we can't reach this point until we understand ourselves and implement learnings from our brain inside of a computer and reach this interconnectivity, break away from these single task networks. And so we need to reach general intelligence to solve these problems. And the current method that we're doing this is through an algorithm called a neural network. It's the current imitation of the human brain. And it's important to understand the differences between a neural network and our brain in order to know what we need to fix to get to AGI. So a neural network is composed of mathematical units called neurons. They give an input, they give out an output. And they're stacked on top of each other in columns called layers, and each one receives information from the previous one. Thus it learns. It's a very basic representation. Now what we've been doing over the past few years to get to more general AI, to stronger AI, is making these networks deeper, with more connections and more neurons. Our game is to learn more, to be more general, right? But deeper networks don't necessarily translate into consciousness and creativity. Simply making networks bigger won't cut it, because consciousness is more complex than that. In fact, current neuroscience research suggests that consciousness is an inherent part of our brain resulting from the interactions of the different parts in concert, not just a specific place in our brain. We don't have a part of our brain that where consciousness resides, and it's an emergent property. And so what we need to be doing is thinking, how can we restructure these networks to be more like the brain, to focus on the interaction between them? Now, you might notice another important difference. This network is very linear. Information travels in a straight line. Whereas this network is a straight line, the brain is organic. It loops in and on itself many times. And this linear structure is stopping us from getting to more general AI, to solving these problems. So if we know that this is how the brain works, why are we making neural networks in such a linear fashion? It's because of a massive limitation. The only widely used and generally accepted learning method for AI called gradient descent relies on this structure, this linear structure. In fact, when you apply it to a brain-like structure, it fails. It can't learn. And so we need to be fixing these problems if we want to get to AGI. My research at the University of Waterloo in Toronto, in Waterloo, Canada, has been focused on creating a new neural network that's more like the brain, but not only a new neural network, actually creating a new algorithm, a new way of learning that could work on this structure, that takes away gradient descent's limitations. But let's say we achieve AGI. We get it. The questions that people are asking is, if when AI is good at everything, what will humans do? What will happen to us? What are the dangers? With every new innovation, there comes positive and negative possibilities. And it's our responsibility to work on them. But the real danger in AI lies in what we can't control. As we code the next generation, the future of AI, and set its goals, what's the danger? It's sub-goals. Sub-goals are a lesser goal that forms in part of a greater goal. So if I tell an AI, improve living conditions on Earth, that's its main goal. But what if its sub-goal is to eradicate half the population to improve living conditions? Obviously, that's not ideal, right? So what do we need to do to avoid these sub-goals? What do we need to do to ensure goal alignment between AI and humans? We're thinking of doing this through encoding values into a machine. Human values. Why? Because values can't be broken. Values can't be broken. But this brings two problems when we start encoding values, a technical and a political problem. The technical, how do we encode values? We simply don't know how to do that, values that can't be broken, even through an iterative learning process. The political aspect, as cultures change around the world, values change across the world. So which values will we encode into these machines? We cannot stop progress, we can only prepare for the future. We need to be asking these questions and trying to solve, find solutions. And another key point is education. More specifically, AI education. We need to teach the next generation about AI so that they understand the technology and not grow up fearing the technology. Because we fear what we don't understand, and fear drives irrationality. AGI will enable us to solve some of the most important problems, the toughest problems, the most exciting problems of the future. But we need to ensure harmony between humanity and an entity like AGI. We need to create a seamless pathway that connects the two entities and ensures goal alignment. But not only will integrating AI and humanity together solve this problem of the danger of AI, but it'll give us computational powers that we have only dreamed of. And with these newfound powers, we will solve the problems of the future. Thank you.